Hello, so today I'm going to be bubble glazing. Well, that didn't taste great. Hello and welcome to my video. So in this video, I'll be teaching you how to bubble glaze. So basically, I'm taking a ceramics class and I needed to bubble glaze and I was learning from my teacher, so why not make a video about it? And I thought I would try to teach you guys something. So basically, bubble glazing is like a technique you can use to get this type of glazing on your bisque-fired clay. So I started off by grabbing my supplies, which was some glazings, or some of your underglaze, and some water, a paintbrush, and some newspaper. So these measurements are kind of a guesstimate, but I used about 1.5 teaspoons of glaze, around 5 to 6 teaspoons of water, and about 3/4 teaspoons of soap. And if it's not bubbly enough when you use this formula, because I didn't really measure it out, I just kind of guesstimated what I thought I was adding. But if it's not bubbly enough, add more soap. And if it's not, if it doesn't have much glaze in it and it kind of is too transparent, then I'd say add more glaze. But basically, I mixed up that mixture and got right to work. And I just started blowing bubbles inside my cup after mixing up the formula pretty well. And then I covered the whole cup, which is, I made this hard slab cup in my last video, I think. In my last ceramics video. And I made this teapot a long while ago. It was like maybe 4 ceramics videos ago. It was like my second ceramics video I've ever posted. But I wanted to glaze both of these, as you saw in the beginning, a bubble glaze. So what I did was I put bubbles all over it. I covered the whole cup in bubble glaze. Then I started blowing the bubbles off. Oh, also, it's very important to keep this in mind. Don't get glaze on the bottom of the cup. You can see I got a little on there, which I'll have to wipe off before I put in the kiln. But if you get glaze on the bottom, on the cup, or on your piece of pottery that you're firing, and then you put it inside the kiln, then the glaze could stick to the kiln, and you won't be able to get it out, and it might crack. So that's not very good. But then I started blowing off the bubbles right here, and it came off pretty easy. It didn't smudge that much, because it wasn't that watered down. And then this is my cup. So the bubbles came out great, and they were very, they were very clear and defined in the where the bubbles laid on the cup. Then I wanted to make a part of the cup that was fully glazed, like solid color black, because I used black for this cup. And so I glazed the inside of my cup, a dark black glaze on the inside, and I was considering glazing the handle, but I decided not to because I was going to do that for the teapot, and I wanted the teapot to look a little better, or not better, but just look more creative and individual. I don't know. Anyways, the teapot was really weird, though. When I tried to do the bubble glaze on one side, it kind of smudged a little bit and got a little messy. But for any tips, if you're actually trying this, and if you are, definitely like tag me on Instagram. My Instagram's in the description, or leave a comment on the video and let me know how it went. But if you're doing this and you're trying it, just keep in mind your like curves and the way you're using this on a bisque-fired piece of pottery, because it's kind of hard to do it. Like for my teapot here, it was kind of hard to do it because the glazing didn't get into some of the cracks and crevices and turns of the teapot as I expected it was gonna. But it was pretty easy to do that on the cup. The handle was a little challenging, but it went great. I think it came out awesome. My teacher, Miss Johnson, if you're watching this, hello. But she's my ceramics teacher, and she did like a demonstration video on how to do this. So I figured, why not, make a video about it too, and try to teach another fellow artist. So if you guys check this out, if you guys try this out, definitely tag me, leave a comment. This is it up close. I love the little details that the bubble leaves, and I think it looks pretty cool. So leave a comment, like, subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.